This video is a collaboration with Tom from Aspect Science. Make sure you check out his channel after this video.
Hey everyone, I'm Tom from Aspect Science, and I'm here to talk to you about terraforming Mars. Although our planet is big and full of lots of natural resources, they will not last forever. As the population of Earth continues to climb, all these resources we have will continue to diminish. As a result, we will eventually need to look elsewhere to maintain our ever-growing needs. Naturally, we will turn our attentions towards our nearest neighbour, Mars. Getting there, creating a colony, and living off the planet's resources will be extremely difficult tasks that could be a reality in our lifetime. But can we go a huge step further and one day terraform Mars so that we can call it a true home from home? So, what is terraforming? Terraforming is the hypothetical process of manipulating a planet's atmosphere, temperature, and ecology in order to make it Earth-like and suitable for humans to live on. Mars was once a very geologically active planet with vast seas, tectonic processes, volcanoes, and a strong magnetic field and a thick atmosphere. But sadly, due to its small size, it cooled quickly and was unable to maintain its magnetic field. And as the magnetic field weakened, the sun stripped away its atmosphere. Today, Mars's atmosphere is still present, but it is extremely thin. Its atmospheric pressure being only about 0.6% of Earth's. It is still losing 100 grams of atmosphere every second, which is the equivalent of around a burger every second. One of the key factors required for terraforming would be the need to raise temperatures, with the average temperature on Mars being about minus 60 degrees Celsius. The easiest way to make the planet warmer would be to significantly increase carbon dioxide levels. Carbon dioxide is the most common greenhouse gas available on the planet and would help thicken the atmosphere in order to raise temperatures. Although our current ability to carry out such a gargantuan task is way beyond us, and will most likely be the case for many centuries yet, there are theories about how we might one day be able to achieve turning Mars into a fully fledged home. And here are some of those theories.
Hey, just a really quick note. We have just made a Discord server where you can come and chat about this and future videos with us. Come and join the conversation. Link in the description below. Now back to the video. Enjoy!
First up is releasing CO2 gases that are trapped within rocks and the polar ice caps. However, it has been calculated that the amounts available for extraction would not be anywhere near enough to raise the temperature to the levels required. So this method would have to work in conjunction with other possible plans, like bombarding the planet with rockets carrying greenhouse gases over a long period of time. Or maybe advancement in future technologies would be able to extract more of the trapped CO2.
Uh-oh.
Elon Musk has suggested that the quickest way to raise temperature levels would be to simply nuke the planet. But this method would come with huge risks. It could trigger a nuclear winter, whereby the explosions create so much dust it blocks out the sunlight completely and cools the planet further. NASA has already ruled out such a radical approach, as this would compromise the planet's natural environment. Another idea is orbital mirrors. Yes, you heard correctly. Giant mirrors positioned around the planet could redirect sunlight and its heat directly onto the planet's surface, or even be positioned to melt ice deposits to release CO2. Artificial magnetospheres may also play important roles in terraforming. This method would significantly reduce solar winds that are currently stripping the atmosphere, and simulations show that the atmospheric pressure could recover to about 50% of Earth's atmosphere within years. There are two options for this. One is by building a system of refrigerated latitudinal superconducting rings across the planet's surface, creating the magnetosphere on the planet, or by placing a powerful magnetic dipole in the space between the Sun and Mars, deflecting the solar winds away before it gets anywhere near the planet. Another method that has been proposed is by redirecting asteroids to crash into the surface where ground ice is abundant, which would create meltwater lakes that can be sustained for thousands of years. Although this method wouldn't be feasible in terraforming the whole planet, it would allow for small areas of concentrated terraforming to feed off the water lake that was created at the impact site, creating domes to protect the lake to grow forests that would supply oxygen to colonies. This would be useful in the early stages of the planet's colonization. Earth is our home in the universe, and will be for the foreseeable future. But one day, we will need to move out. We are slowly turning our thoughts and theories towards outer space and Mars in our quest to be a multi-planetary civilization. Theories that sound like something out of a futuristic sci-fi film are gradually becoming realistic, and as technology continues to evolve, it really could happen sooner than you think. Do you have any theories yourself? And if you had the chance to move to Mars, would you take it? Let us know down in the comments below.
Once again, thanks to Tom from Aspect Science. He's creating engaging and fascinating videos exploring topical science subjects.